Hey guys, Trey Bucheri here from Body and Soul Bootcamp. Thank you for watching our special feature on knee and back pain release. If you have any low back or knee issues, this should be a great help.
Hey, Trey Bucheri here from Body and Soul Bootcamp. We're talking about foam rolling here. Now, we've already talked about the benefits as far as increase in flexibility. Myofascial release, meaning basically muscular massage, or deep tissue massage, and also the flushing of lactic acid. So as far as body soreness and whatnot, foam rollers can definitely be very, very effective. Here, I just want to spend a couple minutes just talking about some specific areas, specifically the low spine and also the knee area as far as a trouble point. A lot of times I have many clients come to me with low back issues or even knee problems as well too. Here's how you can actually implement the foam roller in a couple different ways to make that less of an issue for you. We'll start with the low back. Low back. Two different ways we're going to be doing the foam roller, both vertical and also horizontal here. When you do it vertical, you actually want to have the butt of the foam roller pretty much right in the area where you're having any tension. Generally, it's going to be the lower part of the vertebrae, okay, usually the lumbar area or even the sacrum, you get a little bit lower. Okay, so what you want to do is you actually want to have the tip of that kind of right in that trouble area when you're laying down on it. Okay, I'm going to kind of give you an example. So, as far as your best mounting, sit on the side, pop yourself right on top of it here, and then you can actually walk yourself down. All right, so I have the tip of it right off my low spine area. All right, let's say my pain's happening right here. Well, butt of it is off, my bum is hanging off, I go wide stance, wide with my arms as well too, and I roll back and forth side to side, and I can really pinpoint areas that are really, really tight on my back. Okay, so again, if I lift my head up actually a little bit more, it enables me to even dig in a little bit further with this area as well too. And of course, if you want to go a little bit lower, you can move the pad a little bit higher as well too. Gives you a different area on your back. Okay, I recommend about 20 passes per area. So you don't want to go too much, you can definitely overdo it that. Okay, this being said, another way we can get into the low area of the back. So say you have pain down in this area. Okay, you can actually take this, now we're going horizontal with it. Take it like so. We're actually going to sit right on it, hands behind you for support, and now I'm actually going on my low back right here. I'm supporting with my hands, and I actually just got a nice adjustment on that one as well too. That's another thing that'll help you is you actually get adjustments with these foam rollers as well too. So I can actually turn my body to the side as well too if I want to pinpoint the left or right side more than the other. Awesome, I'm actually getting several adjustments here. Real good. Nice, that'll actually help the lower spine as well too. As far as rolling the rest of the way horizontally like I'm doing right now, you actually don't want to roll on the low spine here, because again, when I get past this point, it kind of feels like I'm folding backwards. So basically, going horizontal, you're going from the neck to about mid-back here. Another recommendation with this is going to be supporting behind the thighs. Okay, this will definitely help again to get alignments with this as well too. Really, really good for the low back, or for the upper back. And actually, the whole back in general is awesome with the foam rollers. Okay? So that is your back segment right there, guys. Knee. Knee issues many times are caused by tension in the muscles. That's bar none as far as tight quads, tight hamstrings, and also tight IT band on the side of your legs. So I'm going to show you how to actually do all those as well, too. If you're having any problem behind your kneecap, a lot of times scar tissue, and a lot of times because the inhibition of the actual bone to be able to move here. This myofascial release will definitely make a huge difference here. So what you want to be doing is going to be the thighs. Okay, you can concentrate on either thigh. That's more by just leaning your body over to one side here. So general movements will look like so. On the thigh, and I tend to army crawl with this one, all the way up, all the way down to the kneecap. Continue on. Again, if you want more on one side, you can actually cross one leg over to cause more tension on the opposite side, okay, and switch on and off. But again, that's how you do your thighs. We're going to talk about the hamstrings real fast on the back of the leg. So very similar to how we were doing for the low back, except now we're going to the bum, all the way back to the back of the knee, and continue here, about 20 passes on this area. Okay, and again, you can make more tension on one leg by crossing and continuing here. Adds more pressure on that one side, definitely gets in there. Okay, and the opposite side, same deal. The gluteals is another one as well. Okay, so you can get around the glutes, just sit right on it, and you can do the exact same thing, moving from left to right to put more tension on one side. Really, really good for that release. Now the IT band. The IT band is definitely supposed to be more uncomfortable. It's definitely one of those things that takes a little brunt out of you. This runs along the side of the leg. So when you're doing the IT, you're gonna be going from the hip all the way down to the side of the knee on the side of the leg, basically right here. And again, you're gonna be doing it in a couple different ways. So what I'll do is I'll lay right down on my waist on my forearm. This is a good starting point. You'll notice with my opposite leg here, I'm actually causing a support system. You'll see me in front and behind as well, because it'll hit the different areas of the IT. So I'm in front, again, you'll see my hip juts a little bit far forward. So now we're hitting a little bit more of the front thigh as well too with the IT. So I'm gonna bring this all the way up to my knee and all the way back down. And again, I'm gonna do about 10 passes like so. And then I'm gonna actually go like this, leg behind, and I'm gonna do 10 passes this way. Now this brings a little bit more to the back of my leg. It gets a little more to the side of the IT as well too. All the way down to the hip, and again, that was two passes right there. So I would go eight more for 10 on each to get 20 on each side. Flip over the opposite side, guys. And that is gonna really help a lot of knee pain that's going as well too. One final thing for knee pain, you can actually do the anterior tibialis as well too. So we got the front of the thigh all the way down. Now we're gonna talk about this area here, the muscles in the front. You can actually literally kneel right on the foam roller, and we're actually gonna bring it down the shins, all the way up, roll it down. You can do the exact same thing as far as moving your feet in and out, pointing your toes in and out as well, focus on the other areas of the anterior tibialis. But this has been a special edition for low back pain especially, and also knee pain in the chronic style, to actually get things loosened up and use it in a forceful method. Guys, Body and Soul Bootcamp, Triple Cherry here. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll catch you real soon.